Hi, and welcome to the Blue Shirt Club.
If you haven't already put on your blue shirt, go and do it now.
Consult your programming guide. This week, we're playing on the blue shirts.
You gotta love a band with a goal, a dream, an ideal. Now, for the Love Tractor, a band from Georgia, their dream was to buy a PA, a public address system for a singer. Unfortunately, they were broke, so they fell back on Plan B. They became an instrumental group. Then they made money. Then they bought a PA, so then they could sing. Then everyone said they sounded like REM. Then REM got famous. Now the Love Tractor sounds like the Love Tractor, so their dream came true. Here's Venice. Love Tractor.
Have you ever... The Love Tractor.
Have you ever used a Love Tractor?
No, I haven't been able to move up to Love Tractor yet. Mm-hmm. I started with Weed... What is it? The Weed Popper, was the first thing, and then the Fabulous Garden Weasel. Mm-hmm. But I haven't quite now. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of scared of that.
Now, these guys sometimes masquerade as another band called the Wheel of Cheese.
No. Yeah, the Wheel of Cheese?
They do covers. They've done, like, Gap Band and the Tramps Disco Inferno.
Very good.
Strange. Now, one of my very favorite artists is Guns N' Roses. I'm sure you knew that.
He's lying.
And they're the feature in tonight's pop quiz.
He's lying. In the big business food chain, there are those who come up with the ideas and those who use them. Those who get credit and fame and those who get passed over. Wire has been passed over, and although lots of acts have been influenced by this quartet from London, not a lot of acts admit to it. One of the few that do is REM. Michael Stipe, in particular, is said to have culled his vocal style from Wire's minimalist sounds. So put your fingers in your ears, because it's Wire with eardrum buzz. There's Graham Lewis. Who we saw a couple weeks ago with He Said, right? Mm-hmm. And this week we see him with his band Wire.
Yeah.
He Said isn't actually his band, though.
Right, it's a Splinter band.
It's a Splinter.
I got it right here.
A Splinter band.
Right.
And we also saw in that video a lot of big superstars, like that woman who sounds like a boot being pulled out of the
mud. Bjork from the Sugar Cubes.
Right, from the Sugar Cubes. And Depeche Mode. Depeche Mode and the
Nude Order.
They should have, Q-Tip should sponsor that band if they're doing that bzzz thing in the ear all the time. I think Q-Tip, you need a corporate sponsor if you're a big band going on a big tours, and here's the big list of big corporate sponsors.
We've got a video now by a band that, frankly, I don't know much about. The band is the 10,000 Maniacs, and I know I should know more about them, but I don't. They're just one of these bands that gets successful, but somehow gets right past me. They've had two major releases, both on Elektra Records, but I have yet to hear even one of their songs. They've toured with REM and Tracy Chapman, but somehow I missed them. I don't know, they didn't come to town or something. As a matter of fact, the video we're going to watch now, I haven't even had a chance to look at. It's been around here for about a week or so. I just haven't had a chance to watch it. So it's going to be a first... What are you looking at? Jeez, here I'm trying to talk to you. You're not even paying attention to me. Well, anyway, here's the 10,000 Maniacs. I was there. I was there where they shot that video.
Every week. You say you were at the place where they shot a video.
It's at a place called the Hotel Anthonium in Chautauqua, New York.
Last week we had a video that was underwater. You said you held your breath the whole time they shot it.
It's in Chautauqua, New York.
Okay.
It's just up the lake from Jamestown, New York, which is the hometown of the 10,000
Maniacs. And what were you doing there?
I was, why was I there?
Yeah, why were you there?
I was having dinner.
And you, with one person, special person, person we can name names
now? I was having dinner with two people.
Two people, a three-way? Is that what it was? A little menage a trois dinner?
What are you insinuating? Just
little,
what are you insinuating?
Dinner? You probably took it on the company? The company paid for it? I'm sure there's a radio station in Chautauqua, New York, and they're probably playing some tunes that we'll name tonight. Now, do you still keep in touch with these people? Never mind. I'm sure that they'll play some tunes we'll name tonight on cross-country tracks.
Through careful and clever planning, the 10,000 Maniacs have the first release on this week's 4 and 60, our rapid-fire review of new releases. Blind Man's Zoo is the name of the release, and here the Maniacs seem content to make this nothing more than an extension of their last album. Sure, Natalie's voice is great and the band sparkles in digital sound, but the feeling is restrained and the tracks reflect it. The Tragically Hip are next with their self-titled release. Cut through the layers of guitars in Western progressive style, and you'll be surprised to find that the Tragically Hip still sound good. They give us a chance to sample both ends of the musical spectrum, going from quiet angst to Animals-inspired echo rock. Progressive folk comes our way now in the form of The Show of Hands. The smooth vocals recall Fleetwood Mac and, dare I say it, yes, James Taylor. But just as you settle into the groove, they toss in a riff or a rhythm change that keeps you guessing. And finally, Public Image Limited is out with a collection of better-than-average Eurodance that quickly stalls with identical tracks and often inane lyrics. The scariest thing on this release, though, is Johnny Lydon doing rap. Jazzy Jeff, look out. Recapping now, the 10,000 Maniacs stay on the straight and narrow, B-. The Tragically Hip debuts with a winner, B+. The mellow Show of Hands gets a B, and PIL's 9 gets a C+.
A nice grouping on 4 and 60, including the new Show of Hands.
Yeah, a real interesting band. They, like I said before, they're kind of mellow. I said James Taylor, but I hope that's not like a turnoff for people.
Well, when I heard James Taylor, I got kind of scared and everything. But Chris Hickey, the guy who writes for Show of Hands, and he wrote the next tune you're going to see, Time Passes, says he gets his inspiration from the poet Rimbaud, R-I-M-B-A-U-D. Now, you may be saying, oh, who is this Rimbaud fellow? Well, here he is. This is Frank Rimbaud. He lives in Gumball, Missouri, and he wrote the following verse. He is a poet, you know. There once was a Show of Hands whose videos looked rather grand. They kind of looked European, but soon you'll be seeing this ain't no swish Brit rock band. Frank Rimbaud of Gumball, Missouri, and the poem that inspired this video. And you were right, in the 4 and 60, they do sound kind of like a Fleetwood Mac sort of sound.
They also sound pretty folkish. As a matter of fact, the same producer who did Tracy Chapman's first album also produced this album.
I'm surprised they didn't get the same video guy with all the, you know, the half
dark,
black and half white light. And now to change gears, not even slowly or gently, we want to talk about tattoos. We got this package in from Stray Cats. It included a video, and the video was, But in the package, they had this nice little clip about all the tattoos on the Stray Cats. Let's take a look at that.
How about a tour of your tattoos, Brian? You first, okay?
All right. Well, this is a Northwest Indian design I had done up in Vancouver. American Indian sort of thing that ties in over there.
In Canada?
Yeah, in Canada. And this is my first tattoo I ever got. Stray Cat head. But it wasn't called that then, was it?
The cat's head.
It's just a cat with a quiff. And then I got all this mess down here. Dragon. It ties into my Gretsch guitar.
They started out being something as a rebellious thing, and now they've turned into artwork, you know. Well, now they've turned into a big blend of color, really. Well, you have to even yourself out. You get one here, and then, like, you start walking around like this, and you have to get another one, and, you know, you just can't stop after a while.
I've commissioned Renoir to draw one for me, and
he's opening up a shop on Hollywood Boulevard.
Have you ever had a tattoo?
No, but I was very close to Ricardo Montalban at one time. We went out on a date once.
Very funny. Okay, I know what you're saying. I know what you're saying yourself. You're saying, what's the deal? You guys are supposed to be showcasing alternative music videos, and there in the corner, you've got the king of top 40, Mr. Pepsi, Mr. Irresistible. Well, there are reasons that our next video comes from...
Who?
Robert Palmer. There, I said it, okay? Now, the first reason that we're showing it is that hardly anyone else has showed it. And the second reason that we're showing this video is that it features Robert Palmer yodeling. Yodeling with cartoon animals. So while other shows won't run it, it sounds perfect to us. Here's Change His Ways.
Where's the newsreel? Where's the newsreel? That looked like it could have been Ralph Bakshi.
I don't know.
Maybe the Rolling Stones video looked like almost the same sort of style.
Yeah, I've had one of the weirdest conversations that I've ever had with our senior producer about this video. Trying to decide whether or not cartoon breasts that you see in this video were obscene or not. And we came up with this answer that cartoon breasts are not obscene unless you see nipples. And there weren't any nipples,
so wonderful.
This wasn't obscene.
This is public television. Out of proportion, perhaps, but not obscene. The answer to tonight's pop quiz will surprise you. I can't believe that. I read that myself. It took me a week.
Wow.
It's the truth. He said glowing things about that album. He said it was the best one he'd ever heard. And sure, it's a great pop album and everything.
But better than the Beatles or Bob Dylan's.
Exactly. You can go take your blue shirt off now because the blue shirt show is over. Next week.
Pink shirts.
Pink. Pink shirts. And also Edelweiss. More yodeling.
Yodeling 2 weeks in a row.
Woo.
And Chet Baker doing a cover of Elvis Costello. He's an old jazz musician. You're going to love it, believe me. Be here.
Friday, KPBS.
North Carolina gives us the Canals. Are they as good? You be the jury.
And Simple Minds are platinum all over the world, but can Jim Kerr live and die in your land? You be the executioner. It's Video Spin. $10,000 to make that open for them? It's like
good.
Squished eyeballs.
No, it's CDs.
Squished eyeballs coming by. It's like Traffic Accident Weekly on PBS or something.
Okay.
Hi, welcome to Video Spin. I'm Scott Paulson.
And I'm Tom Downing. And before we go any further, I have to show you something. So this is honest to goodness. This turned up in Pittsburgh News Weekly in their personal section.
Oh, kinky. All right.
Okay, this is an ad. Dominant single white female seeks submissive single male for fun fantasy. If you like Video Spin, shiatsu, romanticism, long talks, red in cars and fashions, then heat up the fire in this gypsy soul.
Woo!
Reply IP box sparks.
Huge woman. 450.
Probably
sitting
so.
Over a typewriter with little gummy little fingers. Shihatsu is that guy that does the walk show on this station, by the way. He comes on right after us, and he makes all the personal ads. We're on a lot more stations this week.
As a matter of fact, joining us out of Seattle is KCTS Channel 9. And since it's their debut week, we thought it might be appropriate to offer up a hometown band. Well, the Posies are just that band. They're a quartet that jangle through psychedelic-flavored pop. Well, sure, Tom, but are they any good? Well, it's got folks who know about this kind of stuff saying that their latest LP might be one of the best pure pop albums of the decade. This is from a release that was originally recorded in the living room on Dad's 8-track recorder. From Seattle, Washington, these are the Posies. From Washington State, those are the Posies. I think that's the first band we've had from Washington, let alone Seattle.
Or as they say here in Pittsburgh, Washington. Washington State. And those guys, they prove that you can do an album all by yourself.
Yeah, they made about 1,000 copies from that original 8-track recording. They made about 1,000 cassette copies on their own and sold them around,
the way to do
around
it.
Town before they got the recording deal.
That's the way to do it.
There's a unifying thread in tonight's pop quiz. See if you can guess what it is.
An eclectic little list now, isn't it? You know, there's more to Minneapolis, Minnesota than Prince and the Twins. Why, there's all that great weather. And there's Bob Mould. Mould, as many of you know, is the guy behind the band Husker Du. He's got a very interesting story. He and the band, as a matter of fact, very interesting story. They started out real punk, and little by little, they started adding a bit of pieces of melody to what they were doing. And that's what split the band up last year. Mould wants to do melodic stuff. The band wanted to continue out on their own way. So now Bob's on his own. This is called See a Little Light. It's Bob Mould. I not told you that guy played for Husker Du at the beginning of that. You would have never known it from that video or from that song. It's a real melodic song. It's very much different. Well, they're actually, their last album was sort of like that, but most of their stuff.
Yeah, minute and a half speed metal stuff.
And now, I mean, he's completely different. He's away from the band. It's like being away from work. People are different personalities when they're away from work. When you're away from work, I'm sure you're completely different.
Yeah, I play with baby dolls and put on women's clothing.
I said away. Away from work, not away. People are recording albums for you to buy. You need to go out and buy them, but first you need to know who's got an album out and who's recording in the studio right now. Let's check that out right now.
For some reason, certain towns in this country just crank out great bands. Akron, Ohio is one, giving us the Pretenders and Devo. Athens, Georgia is another with the B-52s and REM. Now, a lesser-known town that we could add to the list is Raleigh, North Carolina. Well, actually, Raleigh-Durham. Okay, Raleigh-Durham, Chapel Hill. These are three towns that are all within about 30 miles of one another that have produced the DBs, Mitch Easter's band Let's Active, and now our next band, the Canals. This is a band on the brink. They've been burning up the college charts all spring, and they've taken up space in Rolling Stone and Musician Magazine. Despite all this, they remain hometown boys, at least for now. Check them out. Here are the Canals. In addition to the Canals and the DBs and Let's Active, there is also one more exciting thing about this particular area.
The Chapel Hill and Raleigh and
Durham.
What?
And that is that my parents had their first home in Durham, North Carolina.
Oh, hey.
As a matter of fact, we have a photo of it here.
Very nice. Oh, a log cabin. Yeah. Very nice.
As a matter of fact, you expect sort of Dan'l Boone to walk in at any moment and tack up a fur on the side of the house.
And now we're going to have a docudrama about your life, isn't it? The show is going to roll right into what happened. No,
this is your life.
I don't know whether you're aware of this or not, but in addition to doing this TV show with Tom, I also do a radio show. And we just got the new Simple Minds record in, and we, of course, listened to it on the radio. It sounds great. I have not seen this video yet. I'm going to watch it for the first time along with you. They've reinvented themselves again. They took all last year off. This is called This Land Is Your Land. It's Simple Minds. Reed is in the song, but not in the video. I was kind of surprised. I thought he would have been in the video, but no.
He sings on the...
Yeah, he's in the song.
Really?
He's in like
two-thirds
of the way through. He's in that song. But not in the video. The video is kind of cool, though. I like that.
Yeah. Probably. Like that. Well, Lou's probably busy shooting his own videos.
Yeah, he's a rich guy now.
Okay, now here comes your chance to win a CD and poster, or a cassette and poster, of the Simple Minds' latest release. Now, what we want you to do is to send us a photo of your land. Get it? This is your land. But don't send us a postcard or a shot of the town monument. We want something that's really off the wall. Here's some examples. Check this one. Okay, two for the price of one, except beer and mixed drinks. That sort of limits you there. And you just have to love those hors d'oeuvres. What is that?
Hors d'oeuvres. All right, here's another. My question is, what do these people do before? Do they just hold patients up to the window? Do they put a big light bulb behind? And what has Coca-Cola got to do with any of this? That's the question.
Okay, so there you go. Get out and shoot one picture that says, this is your land, and then send it to us here at VideoSpin, 4802 Fifth Avenue, Pittsburgh, PA, 15213. The top 10 winners will get a CD and a poster, and the 25 runners-up will pick up cassettes and posters. Now, all pictures that you send us are non-returnable. Entries must be postmarked by June 30th, and we'll show some of the winners on this very show in the coming weeks.
That Simple Minds tune is one that's getting played on radio stations all across the country, maybe right in your very own hometown. Let's find out what's being played all across the country with Cross Country Tracks. Todd himself has a new piece of music out, and hopefully a new video in the next couple of weeks, and of course you'll see it here. First, because we paid him.
Not next week.
Not
though.
Really. Not no. Next week. Next week we have
Joe Jackson
and Zymox
and Love Tractor from Georgia.
Love Tractor. And you reviewed that album a couple
as a matter
weeks
of fact,
ago.
They did. And they called us up and they said, "Well, you guys just reviewed the hell out of that record. Thank
Woo!
You." No,
Thank
they
you.
Didn't do
Thank
that.
You very much.
They
Thank
didn't
you.
Do that at all.
Next week, Love Tractor. And please, if you've got a local newspaper, put a classified in there about us. It's the only form of advertising we can afford.
And put your phone number in it.
So we can call you back.
See ya.
For a while, and after a 2-year absence, they're back with a new release. It's called Thunder and Consolation, and the clip, Green and Gray. Model Army, the first time I've ever seen them or heard them.
Strange looking gentlemen.
What was the excuse? You told me what the excuse was. The government gave. They wouldn't let him in the country. They wouldn't let him in the United States there for a while.
They said no artistic merit.
Oh, I like
Boom.
That. Thank you very much. I wonder who the judge on that was. No art. Okay, it's got no artistic merit.
That's it.
Sorry, you
Out
can't get
door.
In the country. All right, this week's pop quiz has to do with this week in rock and roll. Way back in 1967, Jimi Hendrix is the artist in question, and here's tonight's pop quiz.
No fair peeking into those music trivia books either. You can credit actress Ray Dawn Chong for turning up our next band, Native. She heard them in Jamaica and turned them on to an old family friend, producer Lou Adler. Now, Lou heard Native's mix of pop and reggae and said to himself, "Hey, this is the same sort of beat that made UB40 and Steel Pulse really big." So he signed them up, and here they are doing an old Sam Cooke tune, What a Wonderful World. There were a couple of cameos in that video. Did you catch them?
Well, we're having a debate about the one.
Well, I'm pretty sure that's who it was.
All right, you know the trumpet player,
The trumpet
right?
player was Herb Alpert.
You picked Herb Alpert out.
Yeah.
And we're having an argument about whether that was Ray Dawn Chong or not.
I think it was. It looks a lot like her. As a matter of fact, we were talking about Lou Adler, who produced the record,
right.
And Herb Alpert, along with Sam Cooke, all wrote the song What a Wonderful World.
Oh, so no wonder the trumpet player's in it. If the record's a hit, makes $1 billion. What a guy.
Some newcomers turn up in this week's 4 and 60, record reviews faster than a speeding bullet. First out of the box is Sid Straw's Surprise. This batch of twangy progressive pop rocks as Straw shows off both her vocal power and her ability to attack each track individually, giving us something different on each cut. John Moore and the Expressway's Expressway Rising is next. For the most part, this band rips off Billy Idol's vocals and relies on worn-out guitar licks to get them through. On the other hand, the lyrics are trite and repetitive. There's nothing new here, kids. Moving on to the Peregrines' self-titled release, wow, two sound-alike records in a row. The Peregrines are this year's 10,000 Maniacs, right down to the lead vocalist phrasing. However, when they do step away and you get into their own groove, they've got a trick or two that'll keep you listening. And finally, it's the Ophelias and the Big O. The Ophelias drift through a psychedelic haze on this release, creating a colorful hodgepodge of sound. The 60s are well represented, but then again, so are the 90s, as the O's stretch and bend their music to go beyond convention. Recapping, Sid Straw's debut rates a B+, John Moore and the Expressway get a D, the Peregrines offer a mixed bag C+, and the Ophelias' creativity rates a B+.
Now the Ophelias are pretty darn strange. We played that clip last week. What was it, Lawrence of Euphoria, which I hummed around the house for a week. I thought it was maybe a once-in-a-life-time deal.
No, well,
the whole album is that way?
Well, the whole album is strange. That is a little more silly than the rest of the recording, but it's not too far from what they really sound like.
So you say you want to be a rock and roll star. Well, maybe you think, I'm too young. Wrong. Mac Johnson, alias The Played in his first group at age 11, folks. He's been writing songs since he was 14. He's been recording since he was 17. The started as just Matt and some chosen sidemen, but similar to Todd Rundgren here in the U.S., Matt Johnson in the U.K. has decided to form his utopia. It consists of Johnny Marr on guitar, David Palmer on the drums, and James Eller on the bass, and this is their latest. It's called The Beaten Generation. Well, maybe I'm just a redneck at heart, but whenever I hear British people doing that sort of that country swing at, who is it, Wills? Help me out here. Who's the guy's name, Wills?
Bob Wills. And his Texas Playboy.
I have real trouble with that.
Yeah?
Yeah, I don't like that at all. It bothers me deep down inside, by God, America. It really does, and I didn't really enjoy that at all, and I like that band.
It's funny, because the rest of the album sounds nothing like that. A lot of, like, real heavily religious overtones.
Why do record companies do that?
I don't know. They choose the most off-the-wall songs. It drives me crazy.
You know, the world is getting smaller and smaller due to networking and computers and telephones and what have you. Well, we're contributing, folks, as we now present songs around the country, around the state, and right in your hometown.
So if you got yourself a band and you want to impress a major American record label, what do? Get a British label to sign you up. Worked for the Throwing Muses and the 10,000 Maniacs, and now it's worked for the Pixies. After the Pixies did two successful releases for the British label 4AD, the folks at Elektra picked up the phone and sent over the contracts. Here Comes Your Man is the second video from their Elektra release, Doolittle.
Lee Jones, is it legal for these two to be making whoopee?
And the Right Reverend Billy C. Works, tattooed preacher to the stars or demented comic on a rampage?
So many soul-searching questions, but we have the answers next on Video Spin.
Freshly mown grass.
It's like the beginning of a race. Yeah. You know, you see it out in front of you, and you know you have that race to run. We have one more race. Whoosh.
That's the way the beginning of a new week is for us here at Video Spin.
You can almost smell the makeup all the way in your living room, can't you?
Ew. Ew. Yeah. You know how some groups, especially ones that are first starting out, come off as kind of overwhelming? Well, Boston's Treat Her Right gets away from the heavy-ended sound that a lot of garage bands have by toning down the instruments and focusing on the lyrics and the beat. What results is a lighter mood and a bluesier sound. With an invitation to groove, this is Treat Her Right. Your Polaroid as we picture the future, Treat Her Right. Now, this band claims among their many influences George Jones and Prince.
Ooh, nice combo. I just want your... Kiss.
A big hit on the country chart.
Yeah.
Okay, we told you at the beginning of the show, Rick Lee Jones and Dr. John, we have that video coming up in a couple of minutes from now. In the meantime, take a look at tonight's pop quiz, which is also about Dr. John.
Video Spin takes you now back to those thrilling days of yesteryear, say 4 or 5 years ago. A catchy and strange tune is playing on your radio, features a whiny, grating, remarkably unique vocalist. The song Mexican Radio by Wall of Voodoo, the vocalist, a guy named Stan Ridgway. That song was both a blessing and a boon to Ridgway. It got him a sizable, though cultish audience, but it also got him a big albatross around his neck. You see, until he comes up with another sort of askew record, people will compare everything he does with Mexican Radio. His third solo release is called Mosquitoes, and this clip we're going to show you is Going Southbound. Stan Ridgway, who always reminds me, he should be decaying.
Decaying?
Because he looks like, what's the guy's name, Griffin Dunn, the actor who was in American Werewolf in London. He's decaying.
The skin falling off.
Well, Jack, I'm decaying, but it doesn't work that way.
The last time I remember anything about this guy was when he did a title song to the movie Rumblefish with Stuart Copeland. It was like the Wall of Voodoo meets the Police, and it came out, "Don't stand so close to me." It was very strange.
Now let's stop for a moment and take the time to smell the dirt. What else? It's Inside Spin. Yes, we're as stupid as Gary Busey and yourself. Steven Tyler of Aerosmith and Tommy Lee of the lovely band Motley Crue were arrested on the way to a Vancouver, Canada strip bar. They were going because they heard the pizza was great, for not wearing motorcycle helmets. Don't you wish they'd let us be rock stars? Now imagine this. XTC, Joni Mitchell, Ringo Starr, and Midge all on one record. Spirit of the Forest is its title, and its message is to raise awareness about the growing destruction of tropical rainforest. Bill Wyman of the Stones, or as he's referred to in the London tabloids, a wrinkly Bill, has snatched up another restaurant, this time in Glasgow, Scotland. It will be named Mandy's after his daughter, his wife. His first restaurant, Sticky Fingers, is making a killing in West London.
Now, what exactly do they serve at Sticky Fingers?
Seeing as it's Bill Wyman, I'd say they served miners.
Ah, all right. The actual band Ultra Vivid Scene is made up of all the folks that you see here over my shoulder. In other words, Kurt Rowski is Ultra Vivid Scene. He's a one-man band with a jazz background and a future that seems to be in storming college radio. Now, Kurt started out at the Berklee College of Music in Boston studying jazz improv. He then moved to New York and on to London, where he put together the first version of his band. Now, when they broke up, he came home, kept the name Ultra Vivid Scene, and started a band without any other members. Here's Kurt Rowski and Mercy Seat.
We have reclining buckets. This would be a lot easier.
With this angle, it's just...
And velour.
There we go.
All right, go ahead.
There you go. The name of the band is Ultra Vivid Scene, and the song is Mercy Seat.
You told me it wasn't a band to start with, and now you're saying it's a band.
Well, no, they're not actually a band. The rest of the guys that you saw in the video are just there for the video, and then they tour with them, but they're not
just guys he saw outside the window.
Yeah.
Hey, come on up. We're shooting the video.
That's it.
I got extra places in here. I even got instruments. Here, just hang on.
There you go.
Here's a gig I don't want. A few weeks back, we played a video by Bruce Coburn. It was called If a Tree Falls, and it dealt with the destruction of our planet's rainforest. And now, Sting has taken up the cause. He even went to the Amazon to see the destruction firsthand. And out of that came a public service announcement that we got a copy of, and we thought you might like to take a look. With the hot rock and roll topic of the year.
Yeah, that's kind of strange. Like last year it was Amnesty International, and this year it's Save the Forest.
Yeah, they change it every year. We got the Grateful Dead on this one this time around, and Elton John,
and
right?
And Taylor Dane.
Who's Taylor Dane?
Taylor Dane's this big top 40 singer, I guess.
How big?
Huge. Enormously.
Yeah. Taylor Dane, right.
If you'd like to get some more information about how you can get involved with saving the rainforest, we'll have an address that you can write to during the closing credits of the show.
Did you know that Dr. John was an ivory soap baby? Do you know, like on the cover of Ivory Soap? Or that he dabbles in voodoo? How about that he once liked to take the stage in big feathers and glitter and enough outfits to give Elton John a run for his money? See, these are the only things that one hears about the legendary New Orleans pianist and gumbo blues man. What we don't hear is that Dr. John is world-renowned for his ability to play his instrument in the style he plays it. It's called Cajun R&B, and he is the best at it. In this clip, we see him teamed up with a very sleepy Ricky Lee Jones. It's the classic song, Makin' Whoopee. The question is, what happened to Ricky Lee Jones?
I think she was reincarnated as Edie Brickell.
Yeah.
Choke me in the shallow water.
You're right, exactly. No, she had such promise. I love Ricky Lee Jones. Mm-hmm. I'm glad she resurfaced, but boy, it's been a long time.
Do you know what one of Dr. John's first gigs was?
Fireman?
No. He was working for Phil Spector as a session musician, playing the keyboard.
Wow. Yep. That is weird.
Yeah. Friends, I'd like you to meet now the good Reverend Billy C. Wirtz, here with an inspirational message from the first house of the polyester worship. The Reverend Wirtz has been traveling the country from coast to coast, spreading his musical comedy like a heat rash on a warm summer day. The video that you're about to see now is a touching tale of a man and his love for a female wrestler, but not any female wrestler. No, friends. This wrestler was a teeny, weeny, meanie.
Thank you.
And what's wrong with Mac Rebinac? That's a great name, Mac Rebinac.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mac Rebinac.
Number 43, he'd be driving by in a like stock car racer.
That's right.
Ivory soap on the side.
He was down at the New Orleans Jazz Festival this year. Just blew the folks away, apparently.
Next week on this very same program, the Pilgrim Souls. Is that right?
The Pilgrim Souls. With Pere Ubu and an instrumental remake of a James Bond 007 theme.
Man with the Golden Arches or something.
Golden
gun.
Join us for the splendor, won't you?
Superstars begging for money.
It's all on the way next on VideoSpin.
Hi, and welcome to Video Spin. I'm Scott Paulson.
And I'm Tom Downing. And despite what you might think, we didn't get on the phone last night and go, okay, like, Scott, what are you going to wear to school tomorrow? Okay, I'm going to wear this pink shirt. And we didn't do that at all. I promise you.
Now, you obviously have come far in your career. You're up to $20 pink shirts.
Uh-huh.
How did you get started? What was the first thing you did in this here business?
The first thing I did is I worked as a production assistant on a movie, on a George Romero film called Day of the Dead. Ooh. And one of the first things I had to do was to go get pig blood and pig intestines to use in a scene.
Yes, right. Was that a union job? The pig blood?
Yeah.
All right, now everybody's had a strange first job. And our first group this week got its start as a backing band for an act called Phil Lattery and His Singing Dog. There's no business like show business. They're the Hoodoo Gurus, and I've been a big fan of theirs since Mars Needs Guitars back in 85. Their latest release, reviewed last week on this show, is entitled Magnum Cum Laude and features a song about the New York Mets. Well, that's too bad, but it doesn't stop us from listening and watching. Here are the Hoodoo Gurus from Down Under and Come Anytime. This guy looks like Bobcat Goldthwait.
Really? I was going to say he looks like Bill Murray with long hair.
I just start screaming at any minute. Poor guys, they survived like a year or a year and a half with no equipment. They had their guitars and the guy had his drums, but no amplifiers, no speakers, no nothing.
All borrowed.
They had to go borrow it or rent it for a whole like a year, year and a half before they
That's pretty much how it goes here. We don't have an underwriter. If we had an underwriter, we'd have the money, but we have no underwriter. Now, you've seen other shows on PBS. They have those messages from underwriters like, the following is made possible by a grant from Chevron, or the Chubb Group of Insurance Companies. This one, you know, glamorous, glitzy, a big budget blockbuster, also needs funding to help it through. So our crack sales team has been out selling the show, and we have a few potential underwriters. But do they really fit our image? We have two here. You see what you think.
VideoSpin is made possible through a grant from the House Call Corporation, offering an advanced line of Fat Sucks, quality liposuction machines for the home. VideoSpin is made possible through a grant from the Acrid Chemical Corporation, with offices and vast array of industrial chemicals spread over 30 states nationwide.
Well, what'd you think? Potential there? Got some,
I thought maybe with House Call, but they just blew their budget on the PBS battle of people with big minds, so we're not going to get any of that money.
Or an animal show. Yeah. All right, tonight's pop quiz has to do with one of our favorite singers, Paul Rogers. Let's see if you can get it.
Your jet, looking for a place to land where you can find some serious rocking, rolling, and dancing. So where do you park it? In Portland. Yep, you heard me right, Portland, Oregon. Then look up these guys, the Crazy Eights, perhaps the funkiest octet going. Are these guys hot? Well, check this. They brought a sweat to my brow just watching the videotape. We're pleased as punch to bring you another national debut on VideoSpin. Check out the Crazy Eights. Crazy in Portland, those are the Crazy Eights, and I have in my hand their new CD release, and you know how most of them are like 5-inch CDs?
Right.
Well, this is a 5-inch CD and a 3-inch CD, so you get an actual 8-inch CD.
From the Crazy Eights. Yeah.
I asked the manager of the band, I said, now listen, since this is a national debut and all, if the album goes gold, I want a copy of it. And he goes, well, it's already sold 8,000 copies of it, so it's gone garnet.
So we got we're gonna get a garnet.
Right up to paper.
Yeah.
Well, this has been a big summer for albums and CDs and cassettes. A lot of people have gone in the studio, and a lot of people are making a lot of music this summer. So let's check out who's in and what's out. That really can't be proven, but we never had credibility to start with, so it's Inside Spin. First, let's talk about Flip Side, shall we? The latest REM single, Pop Song 89, has a flip that features the Ohio Players tune Skin Tight. If they'd only feature that Ohio Players album cover. The Cult's latest 45, Chow Baby, will be backed with a live version of Love Removal Machine, previously unavailable and recorded at Hammersmith Odeon in March of 87. Mick Jagger's ambition to own a Scottish island and the title that went with it was foiled this week when businessman Malcolm Poitier outbid him to become the new Laird of Gigia, whatever that is, for the tidy sum of £6 million, or to translate that into U.S. dollars, as much as Donald Trump made from the beginning of this show until now. The police in L.A. are really getting tired of video productions. As you'll no doubt remember, that rooftop U2 shoot was stopped in mid-action for Streets Have No Name, and now the big plug has been pulled on Aerosmith. While in a glass elevator at the Huntley Hotel in Santa Monica, taping some lip sync for Love in an Elevator from the new LP, the boys attracted far too big a crowd, and the action was stopped a bit prematurely.
And this really bums me out because I've got a friend over at Warner Brothers Video. Actually, we've got a friend over there who is supposed to be in this Aerosmith video. She shows up 3 nights in a row. They send her home each night without doing a take.
Yes, friends, we have friends that are models. A lot of folks wrote guitar-based bands like Aerosmith off in the early 80s. The number of twang and strum and pick and sort of bands certainly did dwindle in favor of the keyboard scene that was happening. But while the synths and the sample music started to take over the world, the guys who formed Sonic Youth decided to go about things a bit differently. A four-piece guitar band based out of New York, Sonic Youth gets all the fullness of a keyboard band out of the guitars they wield, and as an added plus, it gets that guitar edge that's missing in a lot of music you hear on the radio today. Here is Sonic. Forget about the weather. For the Pilgrim Souls, it's winter time and the living is easy.
And forget about leaving, because it's time yet once again for Video Spin.
Welcome to Video Spin. I'm Scott Paulson.
Oh, and I'm a very tired Tom Downing.
I am too. I'm worn out.
Too many concerts.
Yeah. Big week here. We had the Who last night, which I need a pillow for. I'm out.
And I saw the PIL Sugar Cubes tour. But I tell you, I think the best concert I've seen this week, Debbie Gibson and Living Color. Excellent show. Excellent show.
You can tell we're living in the lousy 80s. In another couple of months, we will have survived the 80s, the decade that gave us starvation in Africa and AIDS in America and Imelda Marcos in Hawaii. It's kind of depressing, but I'm not the only one that feels this way. It's not just because I'm tired either. As we venture into the 90s, David Bowie has gotten downright downtrodden. He's pulled a big Howard Beale on us. He's run out that big window and he's shouting, "I'm mad as hell." Quite a change from Let's Dance, eh? Well, Bowie's latest project is called Tin Machine. This is them here. And the clip is called Under the God. This Tin Machine, David being nasty and mean for the first time in quite a while. Real heavy.
Walking off the stage, saying, "Get out of my way. I've got to take my Geritol."
Great band, too. The Sales Brothers playing rhythm section, but they're never going to be known as a band. It'll always be known as David Bowie and
the Tin Machine.
Yeah, even if they remember Tin Machine. Yeah. This week's pop quiz has to do with having a hit record. Very surprising list of people who have not had one. Let's take a look at it now.
It reads like something right out of the How to Become a Successful Band Overnight Handbook. Three West German kids, right out of high school, grab themselves a couple of good synthesizers, find a producer, and put out a single. Now, before you can blink, they burn up the European charts, follow that single up with a second one that sells a million copies. Now they pal around with big names in the German pop scene, write hit records, and basically rule the European female population. For these reasons, I'm jealous and I hate them. But they sound great and the video's fun, so here's Hubert Ka. Hubert Ka, Cow K Ka, something like that.
Hubert's got a thing about women.
You think?
Yeah.
You think?
Well, I think.
You know how sometimes we look at biographies of bands? Well, here's
this is from the record company.
This is from the record company.
Oh, okay.
Biography of Hubert Ka. And it says, the lead singer says, I really enjoy writing good music with good rhythms and good tunes that make people happy.
That's good. That's good and happy.
It's very good and happy. So you've got a few extra bucks to spend on a CD, but you don't know what to get. Well, fortunately for you, there's 4N60, your consumer guide to quality audio recordings. We'll start it out with Frank's I Enjoy Being a Girl. If you like your folk music to bite, if you want to listen to music that covers everything from women's tennis to polar bear attacks, then this is the release for you. Frank's sarcasm and wit add substance to the current folky scene, walking all over the likes of Tracy Chapman and Suzanne Vega. Next, it's Alphaville's The Breathtaking Blue. Wonder what these guys have been doing since their tune Big in Japan? They've been stealing old synthesizer programs out of Howard Jones' dumpster. This disc doesn't even make a good Frisbee. Mr. Music Head comes to us next from Adrian Ballou. Will this be it? Will this be the release that springs Adrian from cult status? Well, it should be. Ballou mixes and matches his influence here from over the years, taking the best of Bowie, the Beatles, and the Talking Heads, and arranging them into an inviting, exciting release that stands out as one fine pop rock package. And finally, it's The Call's Let the Day Begin. Now, this is a good effort, but overall, it falls short. For instance, the vocals are right there, but the lyrics are only so-so. The guitar work is hot, but not consistent. If The Call ever gets it together, they'll be hot, but right now, they're only lukewarm. Recapping, Frank twists the folk scene, B+, Alphaville doesn't make the grade, an F, Adrian Ballou takes top honors with an A, and The Call's latest gets an A for effort, but a C overall.
I'm glad to see you like the Adrian Ballou, one of my favorite guitarists of all time. King Crimson, when he was with King Crimson, what a great band. Robert Fripp and Adrian Ballou. Mm-hmm. Marvelous.
Also did some work with the Talking Heads on a couple of their albums. And next week, we will have his first video on this particular show.
He's out on a solo guitarist tour. If you see him in a club, go see him. Excellent, Adrian Ballou. Those of us who take out those personal ads in magazines and newspapers, we always do so with kind of a touch of doubt. Is anybody going to read it? If they do, will they answer it? If they have all their appendages? Believe it or not. That's how our next group got together. The Pilgrim Souls were sought out in personal ads in the Village Voice by guitarist-writer Danny Yetnikoff. So the next time you see a listing under Musicians Wanted, you might want to apply. You never know where it might lead you. From their LP, Is This All of Us, here's the Pilgrim Souls. I hate when they do that at the end.
When they do... Oh,
they do that ball thing back and forth at the end. Why do people throw that in their videos?
I don't know. It's like people go out of their way to find as many different things that have nothing to do with what's actually going on in the video, and then just stick them in.
And it's a good song, and they do, you know, they play in the snow, which
that's
is
like
good.
Coming down.
The snow. My mom always told me not to play electric guitars in the snow, but you never know. Is there a single radio station in America playing the Pilgrim Souls yet?
Not yet.
I doubt it. Let's check cross-country tracks.
Barry Adamson wants to make a movie. Unfortunately, Barry's a bass player, not a filmmaker, so he decided to do a soundtrack instead. A soundtrack for a film that only exists inside his head. Adamson said his movie would be shot in the film noir style. You know, black and white, real shadowy, smoky, with big heavy-set underworld figures hanging all around. Now, actually, Barry had the chance to make a mini version of his dream movie when they filmed his first video. It's a remake from the hit theme song from the 1955 movie called The Man with the Golden Arm. That's Barry Adamson, who used to play with Nick Cave and the Bad Seeds.
That song was from a movie, wasn't it? Frank Sinatra movie or something? Man with Golden.
We've blown a light. We gotta fix it.
We're on a tight schedule. All right. These guys never show up when you really want them. They just show up when they feel... You know, we've had old Dave Thomas and his strange alter ego band, Pere Ubu, on the show before, so there's no need really to get into a big history of them. But I would like to clarify one thing. This is not the same Dave Thomas you see on TV in those Wendy's hamburgers ads. This is not the same type of man that would invent something as ordinary as a triple-decker cheeseburger. This Dave Thomas is of a different ilk. See, this Dave Thomas comes up with these 3 or 4 minute videos. You all right up there? That look like this. There's Dave Thomas, like we said, not the guy from Wendy's, but a guy obviously who has been to Wendy's quite a few times. And Pere Ubu is the band. I really am beginning to like this band from being on the show. I've seen their videos.
The first time, I know you said you're like, I don't like it. But you have been saved by the power of VideoSpin. Now, your next challenge, should you decide to accept it, is to try to guess the answer to tonight's pop quiz.
And now, to give us a description of every video we'll play next week, Tom Downing. First off, Morrissey.
I'm so depressed, I don't want to live anymore.
Thank you very much.
And Jing.
I get it. Hello.
And Adrian Ballou.
Oh, daddy. Oh, daddy.
There you go. That's the entire show. If you missed it next week, you got it in 30 seconds this week. Toodles.
Vision when people are starving.
My cat and dog is dead.
As you can probably tell, this week we're going to play something from Morrissey.
And it'll be fun, but it'll be very sad.
But first, here's the first intro. Tom will do it while I go in the corner and blow my brains out.
All right. From deep in the heart of Pennsylvania's Lehigh Valley. Sounds like a wine commercial, doesn't it? Actually, these guys are what comes from the rolling hills of the Lehigh Valley. They're garage rockers, the original sins. Now, one of the best ways to describe this band is no frills. No clever lyrics, no fancy formulas, and certainly no computer-driven keyboards. This is full throttle, dance till you drop, primal rock. Now, if you want to peel the paint off your neighbor's wall, turn this one up real loud. Here's the original sins. The original sins.
Lyrics are unimportant at this point.
I like them.
Now these guys, when they're in concert, when they do their live stuff,
yeah.
They play their current release track for track. They take a break halfway, like where you turn over.
Flip the record?
Yeah, the between sides. Then when they come on their encore, they introduce it as, these are the CD bonus tracks.
I like it. Very good.
Okay, this week's pop quiz has to do with what you like to buy in the record store. Take a look.
Success, like beauty, is in the eye of the beholder, right? Well, Adrian Ballou, although not known by the masses, I mean, he's not going to be in this week's People magazine, I don't think, is a very successful musician. He's been the guitarist of choice for David Bowie, Talking Heads, King Crimson, Paul Simon, his own project band, The Bears, and he's received critical acclaim as a solo artist. He's, well, unknown, folks. From Mr. Musichead, his latest, it's Oh Daddy, a story about being unknown. Adrian Ballou. Daughter talking to him about why can't you be like Bon Jovi.
That was a great guitar in that.
Oh, yeah.
Is that a real guitar?
How many necks was that? Six or seven necks?
Yeah.
It could be. I doubt it. I doubt that one was.
Because I know you play guitar.
Yeah, Rick Nielsen from Cheap Trick has one that has six necks on it, mm-hmm. And it works. It could be. Who knows?
Do you know that was actually his daughter in that video?
No. Sure, video stars have families, they have daughters, they have real lives, folks. And this week on Inside Spin, the tough exterior of video rock stars doesn't always reveal the softness inside. Item one, Robert Smith of The Cure was asked recently not to wear his panda bear makeup on a British TV appearance. And after hours of negotiations, the show gave in. The other guest on the show was Diana Ross. Boy, was she mad she got shown up. Item two, can you imagine this man with a tan? P.I.L. is on a college tour with Sugar Cubes and New Order, included in which will be a stop at Daytona Beach. Item three, Mojo Nixon, Skid Roper have posed for the swimsuit issue of Spin magazine. And item four, the road can be a very tough place. The Godfathers have recently canceled a tour because of all things chicken pox.
And what makes it even worse is that if it was wintertime, they could take off school, but it's summertime, so they still just are hot and sweaty and have chicken pox. It's no fun at all. I want to introduce you to somebody. Marsha Ball, these are the folks who watch VideoSpin. Folks who watch VideoSpin, this is Marsha Ball. Marsha's been mixing it up a bit in Texas with a boogie-woogie piano and a set of pipes that'll knock your Argyles across the living room. She's wailing blues on this track, What's a Girl to Do? Let's feel the smoke rising in the nightclub.
Do you have a home address for this woman? Wow.
Very steamy, steamy
yes.
video. From Austin, Texas, home of such great guitar players as Stevie Ray Vaughan and Charlie Sexton.
It sounds like Stevie Ray Vaughan in there
a little
minute
bit.
There. That nice ending part. Mm-hmm. It's nice. Oof,
she's
nice.
Like 6 foot tall. She
need a home address. Have you got a phone number?
She towers. Like, I can see her sitting there belting out. You can't tell from the video, but belting out the tunes, just kind of towering over the keyboards. It's great. Okay, you know it's top of the pops in your record store, right? But what about around the world? Well, let's check it out on tonight's World Spin.
A few years back, a friend of mine came up to me and he says, Scott, you got a real morbid, sick little sense of humor. You'll love these guys. And he gives me this Smiths LP. Now, I may have gotten the message completely wrong, but Morrissey and his boys have always seemed like a dark British comedy to me. They're so serious that they can't be taken seriously. I'm not making any sense anyway. I mean, the songs about double-decker buses crashing into you and girlfriends in comas and hairdressers on fire and bludgeoning in bed, it doesn't sound like it could be funny. You'd have to hear it to understand. Morrissey is out on his own now, and his strange wit is ever present. In this one, it's called Interesting Drug. I just always get the idea that I don't get it. I always think it's funny, but I don't get it.
I have no idea what the woman chaining herself to the...
I'm a rabbit, tricks awful kids.
Something like that. All right, it's time to get at least mildly excited now as we bring you the first ever VideoSpin national debut. The name of the band is Jing, fronted by Arthur Jing, a veteran of the New York City club circuit. He started out like a lot of people do, playing top 40 songs in bars. Well, he moved on from there to writing his own material and helped put together a band in the early 70s called The Shirts, which had some local success and some success overseas, but never really hit it in the U.S. The Shirts are history these days, but not Jing, who plans to make the state sit up and take notice with this track, our debut clip, World Gone Mad. Arthur Jing with his band Jing and World Gone Mad.
What are you going to name it, Arthur?
No.
No, come on. You got to get a name like Jing. You got to name it Jing. Somebody went to a color sale at Benetton and that. Just everybody's got different color on. It's nice. It's a nice look, and the band is...
Really?
Yeah, I wasn't knocked out.
Oh. Well,
Sorry. The
only thing I didn't like about the video is just like what all we need here, another video shot on the top of a building.
Yeah, what is that with the top of the buildings?
He said, I don't know.
If I owned a building, boy, I'd be renting that baby out.
Right up on the top there. All right, well, they don't have 78s up on the list, and that's my favorite format, but let's see what is currently the favorite format of by me, Hani Nini.
Normally, this is where we wrap things up for the week, but this week we got a couple minutes left, so we got a second or two to intro a quick clip by a band called The Ophelias. Now, this tune's a result of spending way too much time in a very small, cramped studio, and the video was shot by band members in one afternoon. Here is Lawrence of Euphoria. What's that, 2 minutes long or so, a minute and a half? Make it a full 30 minutes, put it on cable access. Let's have a hit, okay? Come on, let's go 30 minutes.
I like
Next
it.
Next week, The and Sarah McLachlan. And
the Pixies, one of my favorite bands of the year.
Before we leave, we got a couple seconds. Tell us about the button.
The button, if you haven't been able to see what it is, it's the Affordable Floors. It's a local band out of Pittsburgh here, and I think they're going to be real big. Look for their record in your store soon.
Mr. Predicto.
We'll see you next week.